Today marks a momentous occasion at St. Bridget's Convent, Colombo, as we unveil the newest member of our choir family, the Yamaha Clavinova CVP805B. A gracious and generous gift from the Past Pupils Association of St. Bridget's Convent, Colombo, to the senior choir of the Collegiate School. While thanking God for his blessing and goodness, we know this instrument will resonate with the voices of our senior choir, adding a new dimension to our school's choral journey. In the spirit of this joyful occasion, we humbly request our chief guest, His Eminence Malcolm Cardinal Ranjith, to bless and consecrate this instrument so that every note of music this instrument produces may be anointed by the Holy Spirit, and all who listen to it may glorify God. We kindly invite you, Your Eminence, to bless this organ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Our help is in the name of the Lord. We place this organ at your feet that you may anoint and sanctify it. May all who hear its sound be filled with the presence of God, so that our song may rise more worthily to your majesty. We present this organ for your blessing. Grant that its music may lead us to express our prayer and praise in melodies that are pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
A very good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to welcome you on behalf of the principal staff and students of St. Bridget's Convent to the Bridgetine Carol Service 2023. I am honored to stand before you as a deputy choir leader. Our theme tonight is Stile Not, where we celebrate the wonder of a tender and mild newborn child, Jesus, the Savior of the world.
This annual carol service, we have a special time where we come together in the goodness of the Lord. As we celebrate this good evening, we invite you to reflect and see the hand of God in every moment.
In the spirit of this theme, reminiscent of a silent night, we, the choir of St. Bridget's Convent, aim to lift our voices in joyful chorus. Our hope is that, as we proclaim the good news of salvation, you will feel the love of God and experience the beauty of this celebration. Thank you all for being here with us. May the grace of God guide us as we embark on this beautiful evening of celebration and reflection.
Come, O come, O Lord of might, Of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we gather here today in the warm month of this festive season, we come before you with hearts full of gratitude and joy. We thank you for the gift of community, for the opportunity to come together as one school family to celebrate the spirit of Christmas. In this season of hope and love, we lift our voices in joyful song. May the melodies of the carols we sing echo the message of peace on earth and goodwill to all. As we join our voices, may the harmonies resonate not only in this hall, but also in the corners of our hearts, bringing light and joy to all who hear. We remember, Lord, the true reason for this season, the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. In the humble stable, surrounded by love and warmth, a Savior was born to bring hope to a world in need. May the story of that holy night inspire us to share love, kindness and compassion with one another. Bless the hands that have prepared this gathering, the voices that will fill this space with music, and the hearts that will be touched by the spirit of Christmas. May this carol service be a reflection of the love that binds us together as a school community. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please rise and join in singing the congregational hymn, Once in Royal David City.
Thank you. Son, Christ, Mother of David, Son, Holy Mother of Jesus the Lord. You are blessed among all women, blessed is the fruit of your womb. Your son you bore in a manger.
Oh,
from the book of Genesis, chapter 22. God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, By myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. to you all. Today, let us embark on a journey back in time to the quaint town of Bethlehem, where a wondrous miracle took place, shaping the course of history. In the town of Nazareth lived a young woman named Mary, engaged to a carpenter Joseph. One day, an angel named Gabriel visited her with a message from the Almighty. "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High." Later, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. As a result of this announcement, Joseph went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, Bethlehem, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed.
As the time drew near for Mary and Joseph to travel to Bethlehem for the census, they faced a weary journey. The streets were bustling and every inn was full. Joseph, determined to find a place for Mary, went from inn to inn, seeking shelter for his betrothed, who was with child.
I have traveled many moonless nights, cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come. Be thank you.
light of your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby.
And so it was that while they were there, Mary gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. There were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. But the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." Wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying, "Where is he who has been born the King of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." Going into the house, they saw the child with his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold,
frankincense, and myrrh. Joseph, with a profound understanding of their sacred roles, marveled at the miracle they held. In the midst of a world filled with chaos, a tiny sleeping child became the beacon of hope and the promise of a brighter world.
Could it be this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully? The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? My own, not of my flesh, not of my bone, still Father, let this baby be a son of my love. Father, show me where plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Lord, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king who looks so small, his face and hands so fair? And when he cries, the sun just seems to disappear. But when he laughs, it shines again. How could it be?
We gather here today across time and space to remember and celebrate the true miracle of Christmas. It is not just about the gifts under the tree, but the gift of love, grace, and hope that arrived in the form of a baby in Bethlehem.
Thank you.
Let us reflect on the profound message that Christmas brings. A message of love that transcends boundaries and a hope that shines in the darkest corners. And let it be remembered that the King of Kings was born not in a palace, but in the simplicity of a stable, and that even across our lives, we would profess to be humble carriers of His word.
A reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom to order it, and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
up to the wind on the water. How can you count all the stars in the sky? How can you measure the love of a mother? Or how can you write down a baby's first cry? Candlelight, angel light, firelight and star glow, shine on his cry.
Shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? Do you hear what I hear? In the sky, shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear?
Now have the gospel reading proclaimed by Reverend Father Gamonu Dias, the Archdiocesan Director of Education and the General Manager of Catholic Private Schools in the Western Province. Please rise.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. There were some shepherds in that part of the country who were spending the night out there in the open, taking care of their flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. They were terribly afraid, but the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid. I am here with good news for you, which will bring great joy to all the people. This very day in David's town, your Savior was born, Christ the Lord, and this is what will prove it to you. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great army of heaven's angels appeared with the first angel, singing praises to God, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to those with whom he will be pleased." The Gospel of the Lord.
I respectfully invite His Eminence Malcolm Cardinal Ranjit to deliver the Christmas message this evening.
Dear Sister Principal, Sisters, Reverend Fathers, Brothers, Well-Wishers, Parents, and my dear children, the life of Christ, which ended in the victory over his death on the cross, whereby his glorified body could not be kept anymore in a tomb, began in most humble and lonely circumstances. It was not fate that made him to be born in a manger, unknown and unwanted by the city Bethlehem. It was the city of David, who symbolized the glory of Israel. Indeed, today the national flag of that country carries the Star of David, whose political struggles led to the conquest of Jerusalem and the whole of Israel. Thus Bethlehem, his city, was not just a small town south of Jerusalem, but could be called David's tribal city, the pride of Israel. And to this town were gathered those who could claim kinship to David's tribe and who possibly came from all over Israel and even outside for the census which Caesar Augustus had ordered during the governorship of Quirinius in David. The city was filled with people and many outsiders who came for the census. There would have been a lot of activity in that little town. The inns were full with visitors, and the Holy Family could not find a place for them to lay their heads after the long journey from Nazareth in Galilee. Besides, Mary's time for the childbirth was close at hand. They needed a place desperately, and it is the manger that received the Lord of the universe, not the noisy city above. There would have been wining and dining, music and the sound of laughter, of empty talking above in the city. But the Lord was received in that abandoned manger. There was no royal bed for him, no heat from the fireplace, no fine linen or wool to wrap around the baby, only a swaddling cloth and a manger covered with dry hay. Yet the mystery of God's incarnation takes place there in the cold silence of the night. Those who come to visit him are no kings and knights in armor or nobles clad in shining attire, but the lowly shepherds watching over their herds. All of this show that the Son of God, the Almighty One, has made an option, the option to choose that which is common and contemptible to reveal the deeper mysteries of life to us. St. Paul affirmed this when he said, "But God has chosen the foolish things of this world to confound the wise, and God has chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty." Christmas speaks to us, dear brothers and sisters, about humility. In the teachings of Jesus, it is a clear theme, pride and human noise, merrymaking, reveling, and egoistic desire to find one's identity in one's worldly possessions or positions is disdained by the Lord. Accumulation of wealth without the awareness that it places on us the heavy burden of sharing it with those who do not have is sinful. It boils down to greed and avarice. Hurtful and uncontrolled merrymaking is a betrayal of Jesus, who, though he was God's Son, the Almighty, deigned to be born in such humble circumstances, who lived a simple life, dependent totally on God, his loving Father, who walked the ways of Galilee and Judah to proclaim God's kingdom, who gave even what he had to the others, loved the sick, the sinful, and the poor, the lepers and outcasts of society, and went looking for the lost sheep, and who gave his body and blood as spiritual food to us, washed his disciples' feet, and died a most horrible death, even though he was God, to show us how we should love each other. His command, "Love one another as I have loved you," echoes down the centuries, leading many men and women to imitate and follow him and find true happiness in him. Christmas should always therefore be a festival of love, not egoism and selfish revelry, or a feast of the market forces. We should be careful then not to let ourselves be led into that enslaving vortex of selfishness during this season. We should enlarge our hearts to reach out to others, especially those whom we know to be going through worries, concerns, and severe poverty. We need to focus not so much on the Christmas tree as much as on the lowly crib, which will remind us and our dear children that it is the Almighty God who, out of love for us, deigned to be born in that humble abode, and it is he that saved the world. Let us then turn our celebration of Christmas not so much into collecting for ourselves all kinds of goodies in order to enjoy these selfishly, but make our hearts the humble crib of Bethlehem and welcome him unto us, looking for all those who need our help. Let us remember these words of Jesus: "Whatsoever you do to the least of my brothers, that you do unto me." And it is these words that would offer us salvation. For such brothers and sisters of ours are thus made to become instruments of our salvation. As the author of the book, The Social Message of Jesus, Igino Giordani, stated back in 1894, I quote, "Christ's presentation of the Last Judgment in Matthew 25:34-46 invests the poor, the hungry, the prisoners, the tramps and beggars, and all the sweepings of society with a dignity that is infinite, in fact, divine. Let us then celebrate Christmas, yes, but always aware that it calls upon us to always share that joy with those less fortunate in life, experiencing the freedom that Jesus wanted us to enjoy, the freedom of not collecting but giving away. May the Lord grant you the grace to enjoy such a deeply spiritual Christmas of inner joy that comes from giving until it hurts. Amen. I wish you all a very happy and joyful Christmas and a most blessed New Year.
Oh, chill of the night, we are waiting for, waiting for the Savior's day. Many have come from the valleys, many have come from the hills, many have started their journey home to be with someone, with
You and glory song.
Gratitude is a heartfelt recognition and appreciation for the blessings, kindness, and positives in our lives. It is a profound acknowledgement that shifts our focus from what we lack towards what we have, fostering a sense of contentment and fulfillment. It acts as a guiding light, reminding us to cherish the simple moments, appreciating the people who support and find beauty in everyday life's wonders. A very good evening to everyone present here today. As the choir leader of St. Bridget's Convent, I deem it my proud privilege to stand before you to place on record the contribution of every noble heart towards the success of today's carol service, Stille Nacht. First and foremost, I thank our loving Heavenly Father for the countless blessings He has showered upon each and every one of us, for helping us to prepare for this day of grandeur. It gives us immense joy to hear the sounds of carols ringing out through the school corridors, bringing back all the fond memories. This was nothing but the hand of God which helped us throughout the past few months, which made this evening a resounding success. To our chief guest this evening, His Eminence Malcolm Cardinal Ranjit, we sincerely thank you for accepting our invitation to preside over our carol service and being with us today to share God's word and message with all of us. I am sure your anointed message,
touch the hearts and minds of all present this evening. We also thank Reverend Father Gamridias, the General Manager of the Catholic Private Schools. Your presence here today is much appreciated. To our community leader, Reverend Sister Francine Muthukala, for all your support and for being with us today. To our dear principal, Reverend Sister Sajani Fernando, I want to take a moment to express my sincere gratitude for your tireless dedication and commitment to the welfare of the school choir. Your ability to listen and address your concerns with empathy and understanding is truly commendable. Sister, you have always been approachable and open to new ideas, fostering a sense of collaboration and innovation ever since you stepped into this school. Miss Yvonne Hetige, our deputy principal. Dear Miss, thank you for all the support given in order to make this day a successful and memorable one. We also thank our tutorial staff and administrative staff for all the support rendered to us whenever possible. We also thank Sister Nimali, Ms. Sulakshi, and Ms. Pumika for helping us to create a beautiful and welcoming environment for today's carol service. To Mr. Kishan Pereira and Unique Sound Crew for doing a professional job well done for the audio and lighting, which definitely enhance the voices of our choristers. In fact, we also thank Ms. Malinthi for coordinating with the lights. We thank Mr. Jayadeva Mendes and his crew for the videography. To our very own deputy head prefect and chorister, Chanel Abesekara, for training and directing the nativity despite your busy schedule. Your commitment in portraying the story of the birth of Jesus with authenticity and passion indeed touched the hearts of all of us who witnessed it. And I also extend my thanks to Winuli Balivita for contributing for the success of the nativity. To Mrs. Sharmini Mendes and the executive committee of the Past Pupils Association of St. Bridget's Convent for their generosity and magnanimous gesture in gifting the Collegiate School Choir with a beautiful CVT 805B Clarinova. Our girls surely appreciated this gift given to us from you all. We thank Ms. Shark Fernando and the school tech crew for preparing the LED screen and presentation. Our thanks also goes out to the head prefect, Mithnara Fernando, and the members of the prefect's body of St. Bridget's Convent for the support and assistance given to us in order to make this event an outstanding one. To our past senior choristers, Krishma, Sayuni, Shinli, and Chinuli, for the constant support and guidance given to us at all times, especially for the past few days. Your dedication and tireless efforts for backstage contribution was indeed a success for our carol service. I would also like to extend my thanks to our accompanists, Shanika Pereira on piano, Harshana Vikramasinghe on the cajon and tabla, Sahin D.S. Vijayaratna on drums, Harshana Jayasundara on violin and guitar, Netanya Vikramaratna on flute, and Mariella Van Dot on keyboard. To our retired warrant officer, Mr. Daya Karunathilaka of the Sri Lankan Air Force, Ms. Kumari Abesundara, Ms. Geeta Fernando, and Ms. Gayatri Samrakun. Your training and commitment has made our band to make a profound impact, especially with those melodious tunes at the Bridgetine Carol Service after the lapse of 3 years. We also thank our past chorister and leader, Mariella Van Dot. Your passion for music and unwavering commitment to our school choir has definitely left a lasting impact on all of us. We are truly grateful for the countless hours you dedicated for us. And we also thank you for giving the Brigittine Choir an opportunity to perform at the ITN Christmas show. To our security personnel, Mr. Mara Singha and Mr. Sampath, for their commitment and concern towards our choristers, especially during late practices. To the members of the supportive staff, especially Mr. Pushpanathan and Mr. Bosco, for all your hard work and service rendered to our school. Your willingness to go above and beyond have not gone unnoticed. We would also like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to Mrs. Malinthi Mendes for organizing and coordinating the fairies for the welcoming procession, which was executed gracefully. Mr. and Mrs. Dahanayake, your support for the choir during our rehearsals, refreshing the girls with your soothing hot cup of tea, was indeed an energy booster, which helped us to sustain our voices during these crucial days. To my deputy choir leaders, my sincere gratitude for all your dedication and leadership in our choir. Thinali, Nushaya, and Anishka, I thank you for your willingness to share the burden of the work with me. Your support and collaboration has made a significant difference in our shared responsibility, and I am truly grateful for your assistance. Your commitment, excellence, and passion for music has truly made us grow as a choir, achieving new heights. A heartfelt thank you goes to Mithnara, Ashmini, and Sara for assisting and training the choir, working tirelessly for making this day a success. For the rest of my seniors, for having extended your support towards us at all times, especially needed in the run up to the carols. To all the parents of the choristers who gave us tremendous support in many ways, thank you very much for being there with all of us. To my dearest Amma and Tata, your involvement and dedication has made me a significant impact for my success. I wouldn't be standing here if not for you two. And I'm truly grateful for all the time you have dedicated for me and providing everything with what I need. Your presence and assistance have been instrumental in helping me navigate through various challenges. I also extend my thanks to my deputy choir leader's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Pereira, Mr. and Mrs. Maliyadda, and Mr. and Mrs. Veerasingha, for being with us during these days in order to organize and advise us whenever needed. To my dear choristers, I want to take a moment to express my heartfelt gratitude for your dedication and your willingness to stay for extra practice sessions demonstrates your passion for music and your desire to continuously improve. I'm very privileged to have a bunch like you all. Training a choir of 235 students from ages 12 to 18 who tend to share their emotions through song is definitely not an easy task. Attending and checking on every single detail. Our choir directress, Ms. Priyanthi Sanivaratna Bandot, who accomplished this task single-handedly, is the backbone of each and every chorister. As a past Brigittine herself, she has firmly instilled in us never to compromise on the values and always make sure that we, as a choir, uphold the prestige of the school and Brigittine standards in everything we do. Not only did you contribute your time and your skills, you also went above and beyond to ensure that everything was executed flawlessly. Last but not least, to all our guests gathered here today, to join the Brigittine family in thanking and praising God for the gift of His Son, Jesus our Savior. Thank you for your presence this evening.
and may you carry home with you the blessings of Lord Jesus in your hearts. May the peace and joy of the Holy Family of Bethlehem be with you all. We hope you all have a blessed Christmas and a wonderful New Year. Thank you, and may God bless you all. As we embrace the spirit of Christmas, as we, the choir of St. Bridget's Convent, come together with a prayerful tribute. Today, through music, we want to send out a simple yet powerful wish that is for peace around the world. We hope that hatred is wiped away, leaving only love and understanding. This is a gesture from the Brigittine Choir to the world.
His Eminence, Malcolm Colonel Ranjit, to impart his blessings on us all today.
Before I give the blessing, I would like to ask all of you to give a good clap to this choir and its directors. They did sing very well. Let me now impart the blessing. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and abide with you forever. Amen.
So this is-
As we have come to the end of the Brigittine Carol Service 2023, the senior choir of St. Bridget's Convent, along with the senior Western Brass Band, together with the principal, staff, and students of St. Bridget's Convent, would like to wish you a blessed Christmas. Good night, and may God bless you all.